Oh! Hello! Welcome to Wheel Talk. I'm Rekappa Sadai. Today we're going to talk about the Eye of the World, Chapter 16, The Wisdom. Yes, I've been waiting for this one. Thanks to the support of our new Patreon members, starting today, we are adding Egwene and Nynaeve. Every time we hit a Patreon goal, I'll add a new item to Wheel Talk's inventory. Tom's mustache is next on the list. I'm excited for that. Enough of this! We have a chapter to recap. So, spoiler-free recap. Tom and the boys walk into the Stag and Lion. They've just found out Nynaeve is inside talking to Moiraine. As soon as Rand walks in, Min grabs his arm and pulls him aside. Rand's like, I really don't have time for your crazy. And Min's like, well, I don't have time for you being a dumbass, so shut up and listen to me. A woman just arrived. She has dark hair in a braid. She's part of it along with the rest of you. What? No way. I know her. There's no way she's mixed up in your weird viewings. Min says, believe me, she's involved. You're all in more danger today than you were yesterday since she came. Whatever, I've gotta go. Rand goes back to Tom, Perrin, and Matt, and they go to the room where they ate the night before. Perrin opens the door, and they all walk in, terrified of what's about to go down. Moiraine and Nynaeve are at opposite ends of the table, staring each other down. Lan's staring into the fireplace, and Egwene has her hood pulled up, hoping Nynaeve will forget she's there. Egwene and the boys take seats at the table. Lan offers Nynaeve a cup of wine, and after he convinces her it's not poison, she takes it. Lan says, I am interested in how you found us.
So am I.
I followed your trail.
Lan's like,
wow, I must be getting sloppy.
No, you left very little trace. I'm just that good.
Yeah, if you can follow my trail, you must be.
Maybe now you'll answer some of my questions. I've answered yours.
You haven't told me sh. All I know is that four young Emmonsfielders have been kidnapped by an Aes Sedai.
Lan's like, hey, guard your tongue.
Why should I? I'm here to take Egwene and the boys back, not help you kidnap them.
And Tom says,
if the White Cloaks find out she's Aes Sedai, we'll all be put to the question with hot irons and pincers. Is that a good enough reason for you?
Gleeman, please, you want to intimidate me? I can be intimidating too, bring it.
The White Cloaks are just one more reason they need to come home with me.
Nynaeve, we can't, the Trollocs are after us.
You sound just like Tam. He tried to get the whole village council on Mistress Alice's side. But even the village council isn't that stupid.
Matt asks,
what did my da say?
He doesn't seem too worried about Mistress Alice here, but then he was never much brighter than you.
Wait, is that a compliment?
No, Matt, it's not a compliment.
Perrin's like,
I'm guessing Master Luhan wasn't too thrilled either.
Did you expect him to be?
Maybe I shouldn't be surprised by this idiocy from you three, but I thought others had more judgment.
I left a note.
A note? Are you fucking kidding me, Egwene?
Wisdom, you must believe that they are safer with me than they would be in the Two Rivers.
I don't have to believe sh. If the Gleeman's right about the White Cloaks, they may be harmed because of you. Tell me how they are safer with you, Aes Sedai.
No Fade can harm them as long as they are close to me as they are right now.
No Trolloc can come within a quarter mile without Lan knowing of it, feeling the evil of it.
Can you offer them half as much if they return to Emmonsfield with you?
We have a saying in the Two Rivers. Whether the bear beats the wolf or the wolf beats the bear, the rabbit always loses. Take your contest somewhere else and leave Emmonsfield folk out of it.
Yes, drama.
Egwene, take the others and leave the wisdom alone with me for a while.
Egwene's like,
yep, come on everyone, let's get out of here. Forget we were ever here. Forget my hair's not braided.
Everyone leaves the room, including Lan and Tom. And Tom says,
remember what I said.
Egwene's like,
what did he mean?
He gave us some advice.
Yeah, he told us to keep our mouths shut.
That sounds like good advice.
Rand gets lost in his thoughts, and then eventually the door opens and Nynaeve walks out.
And Rand realizes everyone else is gone.
Nynaeve looks at Tam's sword. She's like,
that seems to fit you now, though I would like it better if it did not.
You've grown, Rand.
Whatever, it's only been a week.
Rand remembers what Min said, and he asks Nynaeve,
are you coming with us?
Why would I do that? I'm here to bring you back.
Well, why did they send the wisdom to get us? That doesn't make sense.
You have grown.
The village council wanted to send someone to go with you, but they couldn't decide who. So I called the women's circle together, and I told them what needed to be done.
What did she say to you in there?
She wanted to know about you boys. Most of all, she wanted to know if any of you was born outside the Two Rivers.
That's crazy! I hope you told her we're all Emmonsfield born.
Of course.
What was that?
Nothing, I said of course.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Are you okay?
He said I wasn't his son when he was delirious with the fever. He said he found me. I thought it was just...
Oh, Rand.
Listen to me. Tam Al-Thor ran away seeking adventure when he was a boy no older than you. I can just remember when he came back to Emmonsfield a grown man with a red-haired Outlander wife and a babe in swaddling clothes. I remember Kari Al-Thor cradling that child with as much love given and delight taken as I have ever seen from any woman with a babe. Her child, Rand. You. Now you straighten up and stop this foolishness.
Why didn't you tell her?
Because it's none of her damn business.
What are you gonna do?
We'll see. For now, I'm going to take a bath. And this is the overall moral of the series. People love taking baths. I'm just kidding, that's not the moral of the series, but in the Wheel of Time, people love taking baths. And who doesn't? That's the end of the chapter, yes. Now, there's something you all need to hear. There is a heavy metal band from Sweden called Katana, and they have a song called The Wisdom of Emmonsfield. It has come to my attention that not every Wheel of Time fan knows about this. Sing it if you know it. Thank you, Katana, for letting me do that. You can listen to the whole song on Spotify. I will definitely include a link in the notes. I'd like to take a moment to thank our new Patreon members, our new Wilder DT, and our new accepted and dedicated Big Grilled Cheese, Justin, Geek TO Studios. You are helping me to improve Wheel Talk and keep it going. Thank you. The next part of the video is the 13th Depository. I'm going to dive deep on the Wheel of Time, and there might be spoilers. So if you haven't finished the series, I recommend not watching this part. You don't want to spoil the books for yourself. And also, if you haven't read the books, this will probably sound crazy. I pronounce this meeting sealed to the flame. So, Min says something in this chapter that threw me for a big loop on my first read through. When she's talking to Rand about Nynaeve, she says, "You're all in more danger today than yesterday, since she came." On my first read through, I was like, well, why would Nynaeve's presence put them in more danger? Is Nynaeve a dark friend? Because of that one little line, I was actually suspicious of Nynaeve after this chapter. That sounds a little silly now, but looking back, I don't feel like Min's statement is totally accurate. Nynaeve's presence doesn't really put them in more danger. They need her, and if anything, Nynaeve being around makes everyone safer. So I think Min might be misstating what she means or misinterpreting the viewing a little bit. But as a drama queen, I liked being suspicious of Nynaeve. I like not knowing who to trust in the Wheel of Time. Early on, I feel like these books threaten the possibility that a character we really love will turn out to be a dark friend. For me, that's a shot that never truly gets fired. I don't count Varin, because Varin isn't really a dark friend. Don't get me wrong, I think Varin's crowning moment is incredible. It's an amazing reveal. But the reveal isn't that she's evil. And there really aren't that many quote-unquote good guys that we love who turn out to be bad. The closest we ever get for me is Shiryam. I'm gonna say something that I think might be a little controversial. I do not actually think this is gonna happen on the show, but if we were to see one of the Emmonsfield Five turn to the shadow or be turned to the shadow unwillingly, I'd be really interested in seeing that. I know a major change like that would freak out the fandom. There would be riots, but I think it would be really gut-wrenching. It's something I always expected to happen in the Wheel of Time, and a part of me is still really interested in seeing that go down. I mean, talk about drama. Some of you are probably mad at me for even suggesting this. That's okay, we live for drama here. That's it for this week, thank you for watching. If you can, like the video and subscribe, that would be fabulous. If you'd like to support Wheel Talk and help me keep it going, the best way is by sponsoring the show on Patreon. There's a link in the notes. All levels of contribution are appreciated so much. We love our patrons. And until next week, walk in the light and keep it wheel.